Victor Rookwood is dead. He confronted me as I left Ollivander's with the Keeper's wand. I had to defend myself.
Godric's heart, are you all right? I know you're well able to defend yourself. I've seen it often enough. But Rookwood himself...
He destroyed so many lives and he wouldn't have stopped. I'm glad I was able to put an end to him.
You're right. He wouldn't have stopped. You did what you had to do. With Harlow in custody and Rookwood gone, the wizarding community owes you a great debt.
Thank you for saying so, Professor. I'm ready for what's next.
All right, then. The Keepers have been waiting.
You have completed all of our trials, and you have done so under circumstances even I did not foresee. You understand now why all of this was necessary. The portkey, the vault, the locket, the book, the trials. To ensure that one with the ability you and I share would make the same choice that San, Neve, Charles, and I did.
Now that you have witnessed my memory, you understand all that is at stake. Not everyone is what they seem.
As you know, light does not exist without shadow, nor shadow without light. Simply because you can eliminate darkness does not always mean that you should.
Even the most well-meaning and competent amongst us cannot possibly know the consequences of manipulating what should be beyond our reach.
What lies in the repository must never be released. Resist the temptation to destroy or control it. The magic that you have so carefully honed must now be used only to protect the secret we keep. You have the wand. You will know when to wield it. We leave our legacy in your hands.
I should hope that the enchantments protecting the castle would protect against an incursion from below.
I fear they may not. Although, if they don't now, I can assure you they will in the future.
Were you able to reach Professor Weasley?
I was. Hopefully she and the others will arrive soon. They know where to find the door through which we entered. If his loyalists are here, he cannot be far behind.
You and I have faced worse, Professor.
Search the area. Must be
here
somewhere.
We'd have to get
it
closer.
Let's not travel that way.
Let's go.
pieces.
I see it, and I don't know. I can only hope they arrive soon.
Accio.
Levius. Good for you.
Professor, that wall, that's the way forward.
Very perceptive, my young friend.
It worked. Let's go.
Lumos!
Ranrock must be getting closer to finding the repository.
I fear you're right, Professor. There's nothing we can do but keep searching.
Rebellion.
Listen, more goblins up ahead.
One less human. Why?
Defend. Bombard. Arrest those.
I won't let rather I'm one of you, little moon.
Good for you.
Pity.
Looks like.
Arrest
on the
left.
Bombarder.
No! Accio. Against Renrock's army. Kill spells charmed off of me.
Levius.
Much luck so far.
Expelliarmus.
Bombard.
We're getting closer, Professor. That way.
Somehow evaded the castle's defensive charms.
Steer them this way! We shall make quick work of them!
They got this. We got here before Ranrok. I can't believe this is it. The repository has been under the castle for hundreds of years. Think of all the pain that created it. This is what Miriam, George, your friend Lodgok, and countless others died for. Miriam believed this forgotten magic could be used for such good. But she did not know the risks. She did not see what the Keepers have shown you. what Isadora showed you. You are now the keeper of whatever power it holds. What do you intend to do with it?
I have decided to open the repository. Its power cannot lie dormant for centuries more.
After everything you've seen, what about Isadora's fate?
Isadora wasted her ability trying to save people from themselves. I will not let others dictate what I do with this... my... power.
You cannot possibly mean that. You, of all wizard kind, are wholly aware of the misery and pain that that could cause.
The arrogance of wizard kind. Goblins built this repository. It belongs to us.
Enough, Ranrok. It was never yours.
I've been wanting to play with this.
Miriam's wand.
If she'd simply handed over the container, all of this could have been avoided. Foolish, self-important witch. Seems you were two of a kind. She didn't know when to give up either. Come on.
You can't run forever, Ranrok.
Give up now. I'll ensure that your death is swift.
There's nowhere to hide now, Ranrok. Let me open. Accio. Accio. Confirm. Confirm.
Professor Eleazar Fig. I dare say he was a beloved professor to many of you, certainly a long-standing colleague to his peers. A famed adventurer and seeker of knowledge, he built a reputation charging into the unknown, brazenly disregarding both discretion and safety, providing perhaps a rather unfortunate lesson for us all. His devotion to adventure was rivaled only by his dedication to Hogwarts. And of course, to his wife, Midi, whom we lost much too soon as well.
Professor Fig represented the best of all of us. Oh, he could be deviously clever, possessed a brilliantly inquisitive mind, and was the most loyal of friends. But perhaps it was his remarkable courage, for which we will all be forever indebted to him. If not for Professor Fig, well, I can say with confidence that if not for him, many of us, let alone Hogwarts, would not be here today. Those that knew him best will agree that we must now honor him as only Hogwarts can, by wisely, resourcefully, justly, and bravely facing all that lies ahead.
To Professor Fig!